Hey Scapers, another Runescape video is here, starting with some double experience gains. Honestly, I don't even know what to say about this. Like, I got 99 Herblore legit way back in the day, and now I'm not even making real potions? And I'm so close to 120 Herblore. Not gonna lie, it feels really weird. Like, I don't even feel like I deserve this much Herblore experience by just doing this MTX stuff. When I did it on my Iron Man, I actually felt that I made thousands of potions, and it was very worth it. Now it's just a joke? At least it feels like that to me. Nonetheless, experience is gained either way, so I guess it's okay. Managed to gather enough points for Citicide. Gonna be a very good item for training, farming to 120 while AFK monsters and just in general. It's a really nice item to unlock. Gonna get 120 Slayer doing actual Slayer, so it's gonna be a big chunk of experience just from that. And all that money making videos where I kill 10,000 monsters gonna help a lot. I still missing so many items and quality of life upgrades for this account. It will take a lot of time to make it to feel like my Iron Man, as I spent insane amount of money doing Warriors unlocks there, so yeah, let's continue. Oh look, what's that? 118 Herblore achieved. Wow, such a big number. Gathered as many protein shakes I can, so I'm 100% sure I have enough till 120. Gonna be first 120 skill on the account. Not that I really need it, but it's gonna be a good for the future potion maker. Not sure when though, but it's gonna be done. That took me quite some time to get it, but I'm finally done. 120 Herblore on the main account achieved. I actually calculated almost exactly how many shakes I'm gonna need. Had little over the 120 mark, but it's fine. So yeah, 120 Herblore done. Now I'm gonna think of a skill to try next. Still have a lot of time left on the counter, but I don't really think I have a lot of stuff to get a lot of experience. But I'm definitely gonna train either Archaeology, Slayer, or maybe Dungeoneering? I don't know. Something. As for daily challenge, I think the best one for the next 120 would be Dungeoneering, I think. I'm definitely not training it myself. I either gonna lamp it with MTX or just gonna do dailies, that's for sure. It will take some time, but I'm not in a rush for sure. So the only thing I found that was actually worth the time is Slayer Dummies. It's not gonna be much experience, but still. I will need to do it manually for sure, as I need so many Slayer points for Warriors unlocks and just general stuff. Not really looking towards Slayer log, but would like to do some better tasks for both money and Slayer points. So yeah, I will see how it goes. Just a random thing, got the last pieces of mining outfit. Not really sure if I even gonna use it, but why not? Maybe I'm gonna AFK to 120 with a Nimica rocks or something. Should make a ton of money doing that. Maybe I'm just gonna AFK Siren Stones? Maybe I will never level it up. Who knows? As for now, I'm just gonna have it ready whenever I feel like AFKing mining is a good option. Someone read that Oil of Enchantment sells for a good amount of money? Let's see. Not selling at mid price, huh? Let's lower it a bit and it sold. Nice. Easy 4 million GP made. Oh, I can only buy one per day. Decided to spend some tokens on some outfits. I really don't care about them. But why waste points on other things if I can easily buy them and not have to worry about in the future? It's definitely a worth investment here. Not having to do Warriors minigames or activities that no one does is really nice. I will try to get more points and gonna try to buy more sets. The ones that maybe I'm gonna use? Decided to AFK a bit of invention at bound skeletons. Let's quickly siphon and it should be a level. Yes. 102 invention achieved. Slowly getting up, not in a rush. It's slowly gonna go to 120 eventually. Doing a money making video about 10,000 kills, and when I look at my screen, I see that I'm just standing AFK. I have Scrimshaw of Aggression on. It aggros only one monster at a time, but not doing that either is not good. Like, how is this acceptable? I remember doing a Reddit post about it, and other people agreed that it's not what it used to be. Something went wrong. Jagex Mods knows about this, and they said everything works how it's intended. So, if it's supposed to be like that, I'm done. So for the past, I don't know, maybe a month, I was only doing this minigame, or whatever it is, shifting tombs. It takes from 10 seconds to 2 minutes to quickly complete one dungeon, and it counts for dungeoneering dailies, so it's perfect for me. Quickly log in, do the daily, use daily keys and log out. Was busy in real life and playing my Iron Man, so at least I did the dailies. So it was very efficient experience to time spent in game, so I will continue doing that. So after changing user interface for my Iron Man, decided it's time to do it for my main account too. It feels really nice, as I'm using it for like a week now. I don't think I need to change anything about this setup. It's clean and easy to understand, so I'm gonna stick with it for a long time, I think. So when I AFK on my Iron Man, I can do some active stuff on my main account, and I guess it's time for some upgrades for my main. Need 2500 slayer points for tool belt items like bone crusher, seedicide, herbicide, charming imp and gold accumulator, so it's gonna take me some time to gather that many slayer points, but it's definitely worth the struggle, as it would free inventory from those items, so let's start slaying. It's so weird to do some monsters on this account, like I don't even know what to do here, it feels so weird. Of course, I'm using bandos at Reaper Demons to deal a ton of damage, and not having binding contracts feels weird too. I would make a lot of money just by doing that, but I don't have them unlocked, so it's one of the future unlocks for sure. Need to do a lot of quests for basic items unlocks like Asylum Ring, Slayer Monsters, just other useful items. So I'm gonna slowly start doing that one thing at a time. It will take me a long time to unlock everything, but I'm not in a rush, so it's fine. So the first upgrade gonna be Bone Crusher. First one of many that I will need to add to the tool belt. Not skipping tasks helps a lot here for collecting tasks, so I will try to do as many as I can for easy points. Did a stream yesterday, so the quality of following clips gonna be lower, but one of the main relics is unlocked, 40 of the small. Another one that I already had is Lock of the Dwarves. And for the last one, I would like to have Persistent Rage, the same combination I have on my Iron Man, and it feels very good to have it. That should be, yes, quest done. Not the hardest one, but it was a very nice unlock. Finally can add puzzle box to the tool belt. Very nice quality of life upgrade. I just realized, I don't have anything good unlocked at ports. Like, I checked and it had like 2 full scrolls unlocked. So it's not that it's OP thing to unlock, but I like ports as it offers some good upgrades. So I'm just gonna do some voyages daily and slowly gonna get to the last region, as I have all 90 skills required here, so it's gonna be easy to do story missions too. Oh boy, this account has nothing unlocked. Finally decided to buy Double Surge. Don't know why I waited for so long, but it's gonna be a good quality unlock for sure. And just like that, another mystery is done. Need one more to unlock Persistent Rage Relic and Ancient Summoning. So, 2 great unlocks awaits. This should be... yes, finally it's done. Let's unlock Ancient Summoning and... oh, wait, I forgot 2 things for the relic. Let's quickly grab it. Let's try it, big boy. I want my relic. Thank you, come again. Finally, all my wanted relics gonna be unlocked and ready to use. I will gain adrenaline while not in combat. Nice, nice. Wait, oh my god, I'm so stupid. I don't have enough monolith power to harness it, as I'm not 120 archaeology. Ah, oh, god damn it. Okay, so new goal. Achieving 120 archaeology as fast as I can. That means all lamps and dailies gonna go to archaeology. Ah, god damn it, I totally forgot about that. Just another random unlock. Doing some research about archaeology and items needed, so I just adding some to the tool belt and stuff. doing research, so yeah, fun stuff awaits ahead. I did some AFK grinding when I had Porter's buff on, so it's gonna be a nice of chunk of experience for sure. Good thing that I can actually buy missing materials for artifacts, so it's gonna be way easier to level it up, and having bonus experience gonna cut the training in half. So yeah, be right back with 120 archaeology in no time. Nah, but for real, I think it's gonna take me like a week or two to get it to 120, so it's fine. 50 million experience already achieved. It's such a fast experience doing artifacts. And I'm so glad that I did a lot of Dragokin artifacts. It should be a massive experience drop after I turn the bone fragments. And at the same time, I'm gathering a very nice amount of chrono notes that I can either sell or use for experience and stuff, so I think I will keep them. So in total I managed to get over 2000 bone fragments. Let's see how much experience that's gonna be. Oh damn, 1.4 million experience just like that. Damn, that's so good. Almost 113 archaeology, so halfway there basically. It should be easy. Change everything to archaeology, same for dailies, so it's gonna be a little faster. Getting 270k experience daily plus restoring artifacts, it's gonna be a nice chunk of experience every day. And of course, don't forget the daily spins. Whatever, it should be fast anyways. Totally forgot the oyster. First one, nothing. Not even fortunate components. Let's see what second offers. Oh, nothing really. Anyways, it's good experience. And talking about experience, 100 farming level achieved. Nice. As for this video, thank you for watching. See you next time, skippers.